It's been rough going for Plymouth this season, and not even a famous mariner at the helm looks like saving them. Lose tonight and they are sunk. They face the Championship's powerhouse at Home Park. A point for Newcastle will confirm them as the pride of the fleet. And tonight we can truly say, together we're invincible. Together we're invincible. It has been a beautiful day here on the Devon coast, and in these parts, they remember those who've seen off the mightiest of invaders, and that's what Plymouth have to do tonight. Stave off the threat of Newcastle and relegation. Fearless, intrepid and illustrious all season, Chris Hughton's Newcastle now need just a point to confirm themselves as the Championship champions. Confirmation of that, West Brom can get to 95. Newcastle have the superior goal difference, a point though, and mathematically they cannot be caught. Forest and Cardiff have secured places in the playoffs. It's up between Leicester, Swansea and Blackpool for those final two places. Well, Paul Mariner was a wonderful goal scorer for this club and for England, but not even he is finding it easy to save his beloved Plymouth. They could be ending a six-year run at this level. Peterborough have gone, Plymouth favourites to join them, though they can still catch those four teams above them. And of those, Crystal Palace and Sheffield Wednesday meet tantalisingly on the final day. But it's simple for Plymouth, lose tonight and they are down. In the Coca-Cola Championship at Home Park, it's Plymouth Argyle against Newcastle United, who won 6 out of 6. Sky Sports HD1, Channel 408. And Sky Sports 1. It's a night for leaders, and Plymouth have one back tonight. Their captain, Carl Fletcher, after a four-game absence, returns. A return too for Alan Judge on loan from Blackburn this season. Four changes for Newcastle. Colaccini injured, Fitzhall replaces him at centre-half. Jose Enrique returns at left-back. Joey Barton makes his second start since September, and 15-goal Andy Carroll starts up top, supported by Kevin Nolan. So they need a point for the title, a point to beat their own points record set the last time they won promotion from this division back in 1993, and 5 more points to join a very select group of clubs, just 3 who ever got 100 points at this level since he went to 3 points for a win back in 1982. It's all there for Newcastle to achieve. I'm very pleased to say that joining myself and Peter Beagrie here on the Home Park pitch before kickoff is Chris Hughton. Chris, first of all, we have to say congratulations. What's been a fantastic season already for you?
Yes, it has, but we know we've got a job to finish, and tonight is the first opportunity we have to finish that one, and certainly would be nice to get the points tonight.
How important is it for you and the players to see this season off with the Championship title?
Well, I think it means everything. The fact that we've been where we are for the large majority of the season, I think it certainly would be a disappointing end of the season if we wasn't able to do that.
Peter, what's been the secret, do you think, of Newcastle's success this season?
Well, obviously the consistency, and I think I just wanted to ask Chris how important it was to boost the squad with them signs that you did in the new year and what is a really tough division.
Well, I think we've had pinnacle moments in the season. One was, of course, the transfer window where we were able to freshen up the squad. We've had players that have come back from injury, and we've finished off the season certainly in good health.
What have you said to the players, Chris, about what they still have to achieve this season?
Well, it's about finishing the season on the momentum. I think what we have done is that we've hit very, very good standards this season, and what we don't want to do is go into the summer having dropped from them standards. And it's an opportunity. We have players back that are available, and they're all pushing for places.
Are they all playing for their futures as well in some respects? Yes, they've shown they've been good enough to compete in the Championship, but they have to prove to you still they're good enough for the Premier League next season.
I think what every player is doing on every occasion is fighting to get into that starting 11. And I say that's what we have at the moment.
Have you started thinking about the challenge that faces you next year, though?
No, at this moment.
I don't believe you. Come on, Chris.
The most important thing is this game tonight, and we'll try and get this one out of the way and think about the future tomorrow.
It's been some journey, though, hasn't it, for you and your squad, like everybody else Newcastle have been affected by flight disruptions. Tell us about your trip down here.
Well, it was an 8-hour coach journey, but we're not the only ones that have done that, and it's certainly no hardship. It hasn't affected our preparation too much, and you know, I'm quite sure that once we start this game, we'll hopefully start in good fashion.
Just finally, Chris, what are you up against here tonight in Plymouth?
Well, we're up against a team that need the points tonight. We've already had a very, very tough game here earlier in the season, tough game at home. A team fighting for their lives, and you know they'll be desperate to get the points, and I'm quite sure that you'll see a Plymouth team that's rallied, and also a support that will get behind them.
Chris, thanks very much. We wish you well, and the best of luck, of course, this evening. Best of luck too, we have to say, to Plymouth, who perhaps need these points a little more than their opposition tonight. Here is their manager, Paul Mariner, with Greg Whelan.
Paul, you know what you need to do tonight. What are you calling for from your players?
Well, we need a reaction from last week at Watford. We didn't play very well at all. You know, like I said to the lads, if you don't want to play in this game, you might as well pack the game in. So we know what's in front of us. We've got to be very solid collectively because we know what Newcastle can bring.
Does the fact that it is Newcastle fire your players up even more?
Well, I think that if you put it all together, Newcastle, you know, they're going for the championship. We're fighting for our lives. It's going all over the world, the game. So how exciting is that to be a player tonight?
What does the approach need to be, Paul? Do you go from it from the start?
Well, we've just got to be solid. That's what we've got to be. We've got to do it together. If we don't look after each other tonight, individually and collectively, then we'll get turned over. It's as simple as that.
What part can your fans play?
Well, they'll be massive. I mean, the atmosphere is going to be created for the Newcastle fans. Every time they come down here, they're obviously fantastic fans. But I think the Green Army will get behind us tonight and they'll respond.
Paul, thanks for your time.
Pleasure.
Well, they are certainly up for this night. They have to be, don't they, Peter?
Yeah, absolutely. The Green Army v the Toon Army. And, you know, it's one of them pivotal moments in a season where they've all got to stand together and be counted. Whether or not they'll have enough to deal with a Newcastle side who are great on the travels, as well as having a fantastic home record. And I think then Notts Forest coming in the next game as well. I think when you look at Newcastle and look at Forest, I think the film is, Dave, against all the odds, you know. So it's going to be terribly difficult for them.
Newcastle have lost just one of their last 30 games. They are a very tough nut to crack, as we've seen all season, Peter. Can you make a case for Plymouth beating them tonight?
You can, because it's the football and it's the championship. They're the two cases you can make. If they have you know, important parts of the game where they will have a bit of pressure, they've got certain individuals, you've seen Judges back and Fletcher more for his you're pushing people in the right direction. Bradley Wright Phillips hasn't really happened for him. So the one real threat I think Newcastle face is Mackey up front.
Was that a fair point we made to Chris Hughton about some of these Newcastle players playing for their Premier League future?
Yeah, absolutely, because some of them came down to a different division where a lot of people anticipate that they would get promotion. And they've done it. They've done it with aplomb. But to the same token, it's a very difficult division. And not only based on their championship performance this year, a lot of it will be based on how they performed in the Premiership.
And what about that journey? Do you think it would have affected them? 8 hours on a coach, although it was yesterday.
Yeah, yesterday they had the benefit of an overnight stay. You know, there's League Two clubs and League One clubs that come down, do that journey like Sir Carlisle, and come and put in performances away from home. They'll be carried away by the occasion. They'll forget any kind of tightness whatsoever in there, because they... Let's be honest, Dave, they're going for the championship, and that's what they want fundamentally.
I mean, some of their fans, I'm sure, that would love to see them do it next week at home against Ipswich, against Roy Keane, in front of a massed sellout St James's Park. But from what Chris Hughton was saying, they just want to get this job done, don't they?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, ideal world and all that. I think an ideal world is get it put to bed as soon as possible. Let's not leave anything open to chance. And it's a beautiful night, and the Toon fans will be hoping that it's a great night for them to celebrate.
Yeah, scene is set for a wonderful game of football here, a real occasion in Plymouth. You've heard they're going to Forest next. They need some points on the board, and fast. A massive test they're up against, though, tonight. The match commentators, Don Goodman and Bill Leslie.
Yeah, it's a glorious evening, isn't it? And one that's so pivotal at both ends of the table. Let's check the team news for you, first of all. Plymouth skipper Carl Fletcher, he's missed the last four matches through injury. He was rated by Paul Mariner as 50-50 yesterday. Today, he's fit to start. Chris Clark, rather surprisingly, the one to make way. He has started every game but one since Christmas. Alan Judge, on loan for the season from Blackburn, is the other player brought in following that defeat against Watford last time out that really has left Plymouth on the brink. The return of Fitzhall, very much a timely one for Newcastle, with Fabrizio Colaccini out of action with a hamstring injury. He starts his first game since the draw at Bristol City back in March. That's one of four changes from the win at Reading in the week. Joey Barton back from the start for only the second time since he injured his foot against Plymouth back in September. Jose Enrique and Andy Carroll also in as Chris Hughton freshens up for this tilt for the title. Curry Anderson back on the bench for Plymouth. That's a boost for them after six games out injured. Newcastle, well, to give an example of the difference in resources of these two clubs, have more goals among their substitutes than Plymouth have scored here at Home Park all season. Well, a fine welcome from the Green Army for their Toon counterparts. Paul Mariner will hope that the hospitality finishes there and that his side can pull off the improbable. Certainly not impossible, but Don, is there a way that Plymouth can do it? And if so, what is that way?
Well, certainly they're going to give it everything they've got. It's been the 03-04 season since they last played in the third tier of the English leagues. They certainly do not want to go back down there without a great big fight. So I think they'll put in an inspired, full of effort and energy performance tonight. But the $64 million question is that going to be good enough against what has clearly been the best team in the Championship?
Well, as Newcastle's season has gathered momentum, so Plymouth started badly and hasn't really got an awful lot better. They gave themselves such a mountain to climb with that terrible start, the worst start in the club's history. And really, even though they have picked up some valuable wins recently, looks like they've given themselves too much to do. But it's not over till it's over. That's very much the message from Paul Mariner. They know exactly what they have to do. That's to win all their games and hope. They also know that the margins have gone. If they lose here tonight, that's it. They are relegated. Just one point to rubber stamp the title for Newcastle United to put a glorious silver seal on their passage back to the Barclays Premier League. In wonderful late evening sunshine in this famous naval port, we are about to witness the polar extremes of the Championship. The hosts within one defeat of relegation. The guests within one point of silverware. A club points record as well. Yet more celebration. It's Newcastle's longest trip of the season. It could be Plymouth's longest day. We'll have the action when we come back in a couple of moments.
Monday night live. 409 miles, 54 points, and maybe next season, two divisions between Plymouth Argyle and Newcastle United. We're in high definition tonight on Sky Sports HD1, Channel 408, and Sky Sports 1. An awful lot on this game. Don Goodman and Bill Leslie.
Well, you have to wonder where the goals are going to come from for Plymouth if they are to upset Newcastle United. That might just be the answer. Jamie Mackie is the top scorer for Argyle, but as the number on the back of his shirt reads, 8 is the total tally that he has. One of many problems that the home side have had this season, competing to stay in the Championship. The party's been going on Tyneside for some weeks. It's going to continue here, even if they fail to get the point that they require to rubber stamp the title for the first time since the beginning of the Keegan era back in the early 90s. And they're now familiar, change yellow strip, Newcastle United. Served them pretty well as well. Blackpool, Forest, Scunthorpe and Derby, those are the only places throughout this long and arduous season in the Championship that Newcastle have come unstuck. And the Plymouth side, with the worst home record, pull off what would be a serious upset here tonight. Mackie on the ball. Away by Fitzhall on his return to the side. We heard Chris Hughton, Don, talking before the match about the strength and depth they had. They lose Fabrizio Colaccini. Well, this could be an early opening. Hall needs to get across, and Steve Harper stung into action straight away. Well, that would have been an opening.
Well, we certainly said that Plymouth Argyle weren't going to lie down and just get themselves relegated, and they've started absolutely brilliant. There's Damian Johnson pulling it back. Mackie doesn't quite get direction on the shot that he wants.
Alan Judge, on loan from Blackburn Rovers in the Premier League, will take the corner. beautifully well attacked, and that was a glorious chance for Bonzangala, who's on loan from West Ham, to get his first senior goal.
Oh, look where he comes from. Nobody picks him up whatsoever. That is a free header from about 8 yards out. Really got to be hitting the target. This is the save from earlier. It's pulled back, goes for the near post. And Steve Harper, he guesses, doesn't he? Uses all his experience to thwart Jamie Mackie. But it's been a great start from Plymouth. And maybe in the first 2 minutes, we've seen what the problem has been for Plymouth Argyle this season. That's two decent goal-scoring opportunities there.
Certainly asking questions of Fitzhall, and alongside him Mike Williamson, and by Joey Barton. Now Carroll. I just hope it's not only going to serve to sting Newcastle United into life. Just interesting there, the way the pitch completely cut up there, and the Newcastle player lost their footing. Speaking of feet, that's high, very high by Nolan.
The pitch is going to possibly play a part, and certainly again, looking for things that may be neutralising. This is just a high boot. Johnson gets in the face. It's a very high from Kevin Nolan. Felt that one. I'm sure he'll be fine. We'll commence with Battle. Yeah, we've seen a couple of balls. That back pass in particular. Saw the way it was bobbling back to David Stockdale. We've got to really keep our eye on that. Look at some of the divots that have been taken out of the pitch already.
One of those four changes that Chris Hughton made just to freshen up his side to finish the season with a flourish. Still many goals that he will tell you that they want to achieve this season. Of course, the title, one of them, getting to that 100-point mark, another.
So many. And that's the thing. They have so many goals left, don't they? Want to go through the season unbeaten at home. They get to 100 points. They can match their best ever unbeaten league run here tonight if they don't lose, can't they, which they achieved earlier on in the season. So it's still lots and lots to play for Newcastle United.
The main goal already achieved, of course, and that is to ensure that there are different destinations on their sat-navs next season. Home Park, whatever happens here tonight, will not be one of them. Do get away. Been deployed in midfield tonight, so Eckersley, former Manchester United player, can fill in at fullback.
It's good refereeing, isn't it? We've got a young referee here tonight, Craig Pawson. He just waited. He tried to give Plymouth the advantage there. He pulled the play back and they didn't get it.
Interesting reading some of the programme notes today, and notes from the boardroom saying how there has been upheaval off the pitch with, of course, they had a transfer embargo at one stage of this season, Plymouth. And so much change in the playing style. We were here earlier on this season to see Nottingham Forest play here. Almost a completely different starting 11 they've got now. Different manager as well, of course, Paul Sturrock moving up to an upstairs role, and Paul Mariner patrolling that dugout area. Coaxing and cajoling, just hoping that his side can pull off the unlikely, not just here tonight, but in the remainder of the season. A massive body blow, though, that they're looking to respond to here tonight, Plymouth Argyle, and that was the defeat at Watford. Not just the fact that they lost the game, but the fact that they lost it so tamely in what was essentially the old relegation six-pointer. Wayne Routledge popping up out on that right side. We thought he might start on the left. It seems to be the berth that Joey Barton is finding himself in more often than not.
There have been a couple of incidents already I've been interested in, and certainly one of them is the pitch. The ball is bobbling all over the place, and certainly Newcastle United, the way they want to play football, they're not going to enjoy this, and you wonder about their mentality. If Plymouth can get that all-important first goal. And I would say the other thing that I've noticed is that for the first time in many a game, we've got two central defenders on the Plymouth side that Andy Carroll isn't miles bigger than. So
I'm going to keep my eye on that. That's going to be a heck of a battle between him and the two central defenders.
And young man, you've got Bons and Gala, who we saw had that excellent effort that he headed over from. He's a product of the West Ham Academy, East Ham boy from Forest Gate. Rita Johnson, he's a Benin international, signed from French football in January from Amiens he came. Nolan using guile to try and open it up, nearly fell to Barton. Dugan covered back really well. Enrique, Guthrie. Alan Smith, hoisted high by Carl Dugan. All well aware of the presence of Mackie, who arrived at pace, overshot the runway, and he ended up in Cornwall.
See the way the ball bounced once it hit that turf. Miles into the air, very dry pitch.
And the spectre of relegation looming large for Plymouth. It won't really have come as a surprise, you wouldn't have think. They've been in the bottom three almost from the start to the finish. They've only been out of the drop zone once since September. And they have been resident down there since they lost to Leicester back in November.
Start, all important start. It was an absolute disaster, wasn't it? No wins in the first nine, seven defeats on the trot. And then about 6 weeks after that, they went and lost five on the trot. So it's been a real uphill battle, and that start has put them under enormous pressure.
You look at the opening 21 league games from day one at Palace to December when they lost here to Coventry. They lost 15 and only won four. Barton able to cut it out in a menacing area. Another of the Argyle loanees from Burnley, Eckersley, seeking Matthews, enjoying his early tussles with Fitzhall. Again in treacherous conditions underfoot, Hall able to prevail. Smith trying to flick it on, it's fallen now to Mackie for Plymouth. Bradley Wright Phillips a little statuesque, and they left it to each other rather. Say Enrique away.
Well, if they wanted any encouragement in these parts, that Plymouth could actually give Newcastle a test, and the opening 8 or 9 minutes or so should not only give the supporters heart, but those Plymouth players out there, because they have started this game really well.
We were having a look, weren't we, earlier at Paul Mariner's programme notes, and he talked about the fact that he felt his side might just have lost their nerve a little bit in that match against Watford, with the stakes being so high that he's failed to turn up on the day too many players. Tonight, is there just a feeling that maybe nothing to lose, with relegation apparently so imminent and around the corner?
I certainly think that what they're going to look back on is how they've done against the teams in and around them. Of the five teams directly above them, they've only managed to win one of the 10 games, home or away. It's a really, really poor points return. Both Watford and Sheffield Wednesday, who are just immediately above them, have done the double over Plymouth.
Nolan lurking. He's a dangerous presence, especially in this red-hot form he's found again. Five in his last four, got both in the win against Reading. Fletcher, who's for Plymouth to have him back in that midfield after injury. Bradley Wright Phillips will make up the ground. Winner's side has a bad season, particularly one that's established in a league like Plymouth have been. This their sixth consecutive year at this level, though usually many factors. There's Bradley Wright Phillips, his injury, the fact he's hardly played at all this season. He was, if you like, the marquee signing, wasn't he, last summer? And another one, the home form. First home record in the Championship, and, of course, that bad start. All desperate ingredients. The first Paul Sturrock and now Paul Mariner to take over with. Barton trying to drop it in behind for Carroll. Routledge scooting forward.
Be relatively pleased, won't he, Paul Mariner, because his team have been the ones just in the upper hand in terms of territory, but had those two decent opportunities, haven't they?
again, the story of the season is that they haven't been able to take either one of them.
Down in front, Guthrie will settle for the throw. Birthday boys, 23 today, Danny Guthrie. And goes Bradley Wright Phillips. They're going to get the free kick for this Plymouth.
Danny Simpson may get a little bit of a talking to here. Pretty blatant, wasn't it? Certain terms. What'll happen the next time he commits an offence?
It all sticks out a long leg. So it might come to Mackie, Fletcher, right Phillips. And it might come down with volcanic dust on it. Mackie. Put in for Duguid. Range fighter not quite set correctly. Every single ticket taken by all ages from Newcastle United, you'd expect it. On the brink of adding a title party to the promotion party.
Lots of smiles. Quite rightly so.
Routledge. Carroll the target. Cut out by Ponsengala. Now Smith. He didn't like that challenge, the referee. Sure he was taken from exactly the right position. That's why the green army are a little restless. Back on by Guthrie. Cut out by Honest Moore Basera. Newcastle can break. Plymouth have a man down. Here's Joey Barton. Damian Johnson. And now Eckersley. Looking for Mackie, but he won't find him that way.
It's a bit straight to be playing that kind of a ball on a pitch like this. To be absolutely perfect, probably better options on right back.
Bradley Wright Phillips. And a dart forward end to the Newcastle defence, which is the meanest in the Championship. That's what makes you think those two early chances will prove costly come the final reckoning. You don't get that many against Newcastle. It's been the way pretty much from start to finish of this Championship season. When you do get them, you really need to take them. They know how to make you pay. For a minute like Bashero is going to steal it away, he has done. Excellent defending by the on-loan Zimbabwean. Fitzhall, enough of a glance on it for Enrique to seek Williamson. And he'll look down at the pitch and it just calls more often than not. Mackie. Eckersley with Duguid in advance, tight to the touchline. Damian Johnson. Emily of Birmingham City. Nice more Bashera. And Smith the man to break it down for Newcastle. Guthrie done a carry forward. For a player, Don, playing on a pitch like this that's so uncertain, you can sense that the touch is a little more ponderous, that the approach is a little more cautious.
I would suggest if Newcastle United hadn't already got promotion in the back, probably the Championship, they'd probably be a little bit more concerned. I think the circumstances, fortunately for them, are pretty positive. So they'll just get on with it.
They've got the free kick here, Plymouth. And Alan Judge will take it. Big boys from the back, Bonson Gala and Rita Johnson, both up. Delivery not quite right to pick them out. Get another little bite at it here, Alan Judge. In goes Barton. And a free kick, Newcastle's.
Well, in the good old days, that would have been a perfectly good challenge, wouldn't it? But in modern football, ball gets away from him and he jumps in with his studs, doesn't he? Leading with his studs. And Joey Barton, fair play to him, because he could have made much more of a meal about it than that. Got straight up.
Hardly featured as he for Newcastle this season because of the injury he picked up in the 3-1 win against Plymouth all the way back in September. Bradley Wright-Phillips, knee injury curtailing his contribution to the Argyle cause. He's been too much of a Shearer. On a surface like this, you're not going to be able to turn and twist in a way to keep it in. Physical confrontation that Andy Carroll might find himself in. I think he knows all about it there. This is Wright-Phillips.
I don't think I've ever seen just under 20 minutes of football where Andy Carroll has won so few headers.
Well, he could be here on the ground. Andy Carroll now for Newcastle United. He's put it wide.
Well, now that is when the pitch maybe plays a little part, even if it doesn't do anything, because he must be wondering, is it? Look at the bobbles, the way it's going. But once he cuts inside, got to be sort of settled, there's no bobble on that, but you just wonder whether he was really positive enough, Andy Carroll, somebody in his goal scoring form. You see what he's trying to do, he's trying to bend that in the corner, but horribly wrong.
Gala uses his big physical frame to frustrate Kevin Nolan. Jose Enrique, this is Guthrie, Simpson, Routledge, and Nolan in the middle, and it's cut out of sorts, pretty well by Judge on the cover.
I recognise that Bashir, the left back, needed a little bit of help. A tricky customer, isn't he, Wayne Routledge? It's a good defensive play.
Two centre-halves. Newcastle, Fitzhall and Mike Williamson haven't scored for the club yet. Might get a chance here, and Carroll gets his head to it, and Newcastle do have the lead.
Oh, wouldn't you just know it? As I was saying about a minute ago, he's barely won a header all game. He certainly won that one, didn't he? When it comes to the crunch in the area, in front of goal, he's the one that gets his head on it. Look, he just pulls off, times his jump to perfection. I don't think there's anywhere else in that goal that ball would have found the back of the net. Gets the direction on it, look. Maybe, I just wonder whether Bashir, he comes off that post, look, he's on the post and he leaves the post. And that is a tiny little mistake, but it's oh so costly for Plymouth Argyle.
Well, now the side that have the second worst record of scoring goals need two if they're going to deny Newcastle United the title here tonight. Will it be the head of Andy Carroll that secures Newcastle United's position at the head of the Championship table? Nolan.
Well, they're only one goal behind West Bromwich Albion now, who are the leading scorers, but Andy Carroll will be hungry for more. He'll be pleased with this, but left-back Bashir, look, he goes onto the post and watch what happens.
Why he leaves it, I don't know. He just comes away. And if he'd have stayed on the post, he would have cleared that. I'm pretty sure it doesn't go in the top corner. He would have been able to just head that away. But certainly Newcastle United and Andy Carroll really don't care.
It's like he was daydreaming the way he was wandering off.
It's a tiny little things, isn't it? You know, you look back and you look at the chances that Plymouth had, particularly the header from Ngala. 8 yards out, unchallenged. Crucial
offside.
Difference.
Sorry, early offside flag.
Jamie Mackie always looking to get in behind. He just goes a fraction too soon. I can't believe it, can he? But this Newcastle United team, they are ruthless. I was looking at the stats. On their win against Reading, they had two on target from Kevin Nolan, two goals. And they won the game 2-1 against a very good and informed Reading team, whereas Paul Mariners Watford, they didn't have any shots on target. Paul Mariners Plymouth against Watford, they've already bettered that, but they've got a massive uphill task from here.
Down in the match and facing the very prospect that tonight will be the night that they do go down from the Championship as well. Fitzhall's header on by Alan Smith.
He's kicking every ball, isn't he? It's been so frustrating because they've started the game pretty well, haven't they?
Away. Carroll underneath it and Gala with it. Carroll just threatened to get away. Fletcher, the skipper, on the scene. On by Damian Johnson. And away by Williamson for Newcastle. Rita Johnson. Seeking Judge. Cut out by Simpson. Now Routledge. Rita Johnson. The centre half carries forward, leads the charge. Mackie. Newcastle now plenty of bodies back. The task becomes harder, but Rita Johnson still up there.
He did really well, the big centre half, didn't he? Carried the ball out of play from the back. Continued his run.
Bashirer. Oh, he's fouled Mackie. Smith quickly on the scene. Bashirer again. Duguid trying to bring it down. Okay, Koulet finding Joey Barton. Now Jose Enrique. Adrift with nine to play for. Goal difference that's potentially decisive as well. It's all looking pretty ominous early on. Barton. Routledge. Simpson. Smith. Routledge certainly has the beating of Bashirer for pace. He's not going to find a way round big Rita Johnson.
Just got to regroup, haven't they, Plymouth? Almost like they've had the stuffing knocked out of them, but just need something to happen, anything, just to get the crowd going again. Just to get a bit of momentum. Thank you.
can say that Kevin Nolan has a small problem. Stays like this, that is what it will mean. Plymouth and Peterborough, League One sides next season. He's got a soldier on. Tall. Barton. Pressurised by Johnson. Getting the better of him. Little flick from Guthrie. Barton, oh, what a lovely ball in for Routledge. It's great from Newcastle. Oh, and beautifully finished off. Now they are really up and running. Now the title is surely theirs, if there was any doubt before. A super goal, an absolutely wonderful goal from Newcastle and Routledge.
Well, the whole Newcastle United bench were on their feet applauding this goal. Look at the beautiful football, and what about that for a pass and the timed run? It's all perfect, isn't it? And the finish is calm, cool and composed. Absolutely lovely build-up play. Joey Barton, we know he's got that in the locker, and anybody wondering, could Newcastle play football on this pitch? Well, they've just answered your question, haven't they? They certainly can. And that's an absolutely brilliant goal. Very, very well fashioned. Very, very well finished by Wayne Routledge.
He scored a couple before tonight. Both of them coming in 4-1 wins against Coventry and Blackpool. It could be anything now if Newcastle are in the mood. Back from one, a task indeed against the best side in this league this season. To come back from two, Plymouth heads may well start to go down. Looks like the side certainly are.
Certainly you point back to critical moments. Again, a heart back. I'm sure Paul Mariner will too. And Gala's header. Then a little bit of ill discipline from Bashira in the corner, coming off his post, leaving his post. Been punished severely, haven't they?
They'd have come into this match, wouldn't they, Paul Mariner of Plymouth, knowing that absolutely everything would have to be right if they were going to upset Newcastle. In the first minute, they drew a smart save from Harper. Since then, it's been downhill all the way, unfortunately. Gala putting his header wide when the goal was there right in front of him. Over the bar that went. And Newcastle capitalising on a bit of defensive indiscipline and turning on the style with that second.
Here's Mackey!
And again, Harper has the measure of the shot. Judge. Referee going the way, that's unfortunate. And you're down, the luck deserts him, that's certainly the case there, and it could just get worse. Guthrie. Routledge.
I say, things don't quite go your way when you're down the bottom. Just had a real moment there, haven't we? First the Mackey shot, it's a brilliant effort, and then the referee getting in the way of the follow-up build-up.
Shearer's head. Smith. Enrique Herrera, a mistake from him, and a lively Mackey trying to get away from Fitzhall.
He has looked a bright spark, hasn't he, Jamie Mackey? You see why he's the leading scorer here.
Eckersley. Smith away. Enrique seeking Carroll and Gala positioned correctly. And Damian Johnson. Mackey.
Where Plymouth have just got to be a little bit more adventurous, isn't it? It was only Bradley Wright Phillips in the penalty area there as Jamie Mackey was breaking down the right. And if you're going to score goals, you need to be getting more than one person in the box.
It's Bradley Wright Phillips to take on all comers, Judge alongside him. Mackey looking at the referee, he felt he was edged out off the ball, might have had a case. This is Damian Johnson, Eckersley on the overlap, three in the middle here for Argyle. Smith, as he has been so often this season, in the right place just to help out a slightly stretched defence.
He's been massive, hasn't he, this season, Alan Smith, played 30 games. It's been a real positive for Newcastle United. Everybody connected with him.
It's the reinvented Alan Smith, isn't it, as the midfield enforcer rather than the striker that he was in his early years. Mackey, fired straight into Fitzhall. Simpson. Alan Smith talking in the build up to the match, saying winning this championship title with Newcastle after everything that went before. Worth harking back to the pre-season they had, in fact, when they took to the pitch against West Bromwich Albion on day one. People were watching out of almost morbid fascination to see what would happen to the Newcastle circus, beaten 6-0 at Leyton Orient pre-season. Just look at the way they've been able to respond. Blow away all comers in this league.
It was important they got off to a good start, wasn't it? Because they knew they were the scout that everybody in this division wanted. The fact that Chris Hughton was named manager of the month, three out of the first 4 months of the season, tells you what kind of a start they did get.
Still in the job full time,
yeah, absolutely, rightly so.
Look at this one on paper, and of course there were elements of it being a mismatch. 54 points between them in the table. Judging by what has gone so far in this opening 35 minutes, leagues apart next season. Newcastle with just one defeat anywhere in the league since October. Plymouth Argyle, who have only won once here since January.
Steve Harper on the ball there. Had to be really alert because Jamie Mackey, it's a snapshot out of nothing. I tell you, there'll be lots of goalkeepers just simply not expecting that. It's a brilliant effort from Mackey, but it's an equally good save from Steve Harper.
Now Judge, he's got him behind the Newcastle defence. Carroll, who gave it away, busting a gut to get back, and he will pick up a card for that. That is for sure.
I have to be honest with you. Yes, it's a yellow card. Yes, it's a yellow card offence, but it's really unfortunate when that happens. You know, Andy Carroll's not trying to make any attempts to tackle the player. It's just a tangle of legs. Alan Judge does the right thing, he cuts across, look, there's no flick of the leg, it's just a coming together. So yes, technically, it's a yellow card, but there's no malice or anything in that, it's just one of those unfortunate things.
First yellow card of the night, the man who got the first goal of the night. Inside the last 10 minutes of the first half, a chance for Argyle to try and claw one back. In by Judge, Carroll away. Eckersley. Smith back with interest. Shearer. Judge looking to flick it on to Bradley Wright Phillips. J. Champions League week on Sky Sports. Jose Mourinho's Inter against the favourites Barcelona. See it live Tuesday from 7. Sky Sports HD 2 and 2. Mackie. Eckersley. Fletcher.
Place just getting slowly more and more frustrated with proceedings. I think they've come to realize probably be a League One team next season.
And the game is up, it would seem, in all senses of the phrase for Paul Mariner and Plymouth Argyle.
You've got to hang on to it though, haven't you? If they could only just get the next goal in this match. Get it. Plenty of time left. You just never know. It would be a monumental effort. Let's not forget Wigan. Just at the weekend, 2 down with 10 minutes to go against Arsenal. So, got to cling to anything you can if you're Plymouth, haven't you?
Well, they need lightning to strike about 3 or 4 times there, don't they, between now and the end of the season. Nottingham Forest away next up, with Forest needing the points if they want to be sure of third position in the playoffs. The home advantage that brings in the second leg. In theory, the weakest side, the one finishing sixth, but you'll know the unpredictability of the playoffs. Something Newcastle United have happily and comfortably skirted. Smith. The Shearer there to intercept for Plymouth. Guthrie. Simpson. Just can keep it in there, Wayne Routledge. Bobbled away out of play. To get the better of Jose Enrique, who actually kicked the pitch there, it would seem.
Asking for a free kick from the assistant referee on this near side.
Be plenty more of that before the night is out.
Years a long time in football, isn't it?
Yes. Nolan has recovered after his out of illness midway through the match.
Travel sickness?
They haven't had much of it this season, have they, Newcastle United? Snaps in. Now comes Williamson. Seems pretty harsh and churlish to criticise what Newcastle have done this season, but those who have said, you know, their style. Here's Bradley Wright. Phillips! Oh, he struck that beautifully.
A super effort, isn't it? Absolutely out of nothing, under an awful lot of pressure. Anticipates the ricochet. One little touch and, oh, look how close that is. Again, it's an absolutely brilliant strike. It's only just over.
you said, Don, absolutely out of nothing. Bradley Wright Phillips very close to getting what would be only his second goal here at Home Park this season. Only three for the club. Finally, and the horse appears to have bolted. He's being able to get a run in the side. His 10th consecutive start, comfortably the best of the season. The former Manchester City man. Here's Judge. From Alan Judge. Cool, calm and confidence from Newcastle United. The champions in waiting. Waiting might not be going on too much longer. Bradley Wright Phillips. Johnson, Eckersley. Just going to say before that Wright Phillips shot, Don, Newcastle have been so effective at doing enough, particularly away from home. They turned on the style at times in St James's Park, handed out some really big beatings. Oh! Another fantastic snap effort, this time by Alan Judge.
I'll tell you what, the attempts at goal are racking up, aren't they? Plymouth Argyle, that's an absolutely stunner as well, isn't it? Really difficult ball to hit this, but again, wraps his foot round it on the half volley. That's how close it was. You see the home team giving more as good as they're getting. Problem is, you've got to keep trying to hit that target. And the two attempts of Newcastle on target, two goals.
If you'd said to Paul Mariner beforehand you're going to have five pretty decent efforts on the Newcastle United goal in the first half, get no returns from them, and that would have disappointed him. Say there's no time to score, just like before half time. We're in the last minute of that first half now. And maybe it's Newcastle United who can put a lid on it. Routledge looks to be on a road to nowhere, but he's picked out an excellent pass towards Guthrie. Just lost his footing. He's furious as it was opening up well.
Looking down at the pitch, looking down at his boots. Apparent reason was there to lose your footing. Clearly, it was affected.
It's going to be unpredictable. It was watered before the match, but only really in the central area. Still very, very hard up the side. Minute. You look at the scoreline, you look at the lie of the land, it seems strange that David Stockton in the Plymouth goal hasn't really had anything to do other than to get the ball out of his net a couple of times.
That's the difference. Absolutely ruthless, aren't they?
Ruthless, clinical, and just over 45 minutes away from the coronation. Away by referee Pawson. Well, Paul Mariner's side have certainly made a good fist of it, but when you make chances against Newcastle United, you need to take them, because they will take theirs, and that's exactly what they did. A header from Andy Carroll gave them the lead, and then a beautifully worked move, culminating in a smart finish by Wayne Routledge, got that second. two hands on that championship trophy now for Newcastle United. And plenty of calls to celebrate. We'll pick through the bones of the first half with David and Peter when we come back after the break.
Sponsored by Bet365.
Monday night, live.
First of the Champions League semi-finals coming your way tomorrow night. The first leg of Inter up against Barcelona. 7 o'clock, Sky Sports HD2. That's channel 409, by the way. Sky Sports 2. Tonight's our focus on the Coca-Cola Championship. We are almost at an end. Newcastle on their way to the title. It seems leading 2-0 here at Home Park. And as we stand, Plymouth are heading out of the Championship down to League One. Peter, have we seen a gulf in class so far?
Not really, Dave. I think we've seen, one team that is ruthless, simple as. And, but for Harper in the Newcastle goal, Plymouth could have had a really, really good start.
Is that the difference then between teams at the top and teams at the bottom?
It is, invariably. It doesn't go for you. You find a goalkeeper in outstanding form. You can't fault Plymouth as far as the effort's concerned, and certainly not as far as some of the quality of the strikes as well. Throwing bodies forward and trying to be ambitious in a game that looks already over.
They have the worst home records in the Coca-Cola Championship. Plymouth, what they don't need, I suppose, Peter, is conceding goals like this.
No, not really, and it's a well-worked free kick as far as Newcastle are concerned, because this is a marvellous header, but we see there on the post, young Bashira, it's a very, very young back four, and he just wanders off the post. And again, I said, let's take nothing away from the header. Look at this, it's nearly behind him. Arches it and redirects that on target, but it would have been meat and drink if it had just stayed on the post there, Dave.
It actually looks like it comes off his face. Is Andy Carroll going to cause problems in the Premier League as well?
Absolutely. We've seen it with the big guys at Stoke and that. And if he gets the right kind of delivery, which Newcastle have the people now who can put the ball on his head in a different area, and the size of the goals definitely don't change.
Do we see how ruthless Newcastle are with their second goal?
Yeah, absolutely, but the creativity as well. Barton's wandered in, from the left-hand position where he's been hugging, plays a lovely little 1-2, backheel by Guthrie there, and then this defence-splitting pass. And again, unfortunately, it's Bashira, but a lot to do for Routledge. Stays on his feet. If we see from the next angle, actually, when he goes around the keeper, he gets clipped, but he stays upright and sticks the ball in net. But what a ball that is, defence-splitting. There's the awareness, round the keeper, a little tap, but a great finish ultimately.
Barton back in the team and starting just his second game since he was injured against Plymouth way back in September, showing his worth. And Routledge, one of those January signings which Plymouth, of course, haven't been able to do, but they had their chances tonight, Peter.
Yeah, numerous chances as well. Not really out-and-out chances that you would say he's got to score, but they started so bright and inventive with a pass, and this is a lovely one to Mackie. Just doesn't quite get enough purchase on it. And they've been very, very good from set pieces. The two lads at the back, particularly in Gala, who are as big as Andy Carroll, have been a real threat all night. But look at the bodies that they've put forward, Dave. We said Mackie before the start of the game was very bright and alive, and that's another good save from Steve Harper. This one from Bradley Wright Phillips. Watch the touch with his right foot to set it for his right foot with a shot there, rising shot, but another good chance. This was probably the fiercest structure we're going to see all night, and it was Judge again coming in from the wide. What I've seen from Plymouth is a sense of ambition that I haven't seen for a good few weeks, and hopefully they will register a goal tonight.
Is there a way back for them?
No, I don't think so. I think, we've said about how strong and resolute the Newcastle defence is and that professionalism that they've got. I think Chris Hughton will be in the dressing room there, say, hang on a second, we've seen the amount of chances they've created. Don't let them back into it. Let's kill this game off and go for the jugular and get that final, the 3-0.
And the solitary point, that's all they need to be crowned champions here this evening. Paul Marinette with it all to do with his team in the second half. 3 goals. Or they're down. Premier League weekend and big games all the way. Manchester United, Tottenham, and what a week they've had. 12:30 Sky Sports HD 1 and 1. That's Saturday lunchtime, and Sunday from noon, the Birmingham Derby, Aston Villa, Birmingham, Sky Sports HD 1 and 1. Villa still with their eyes on a place in Europe. And we finish Super Sunday with Chelsea Stoke. 3:30, Sky Sports HD 1 and 1, and also available on Sky Sports 3D, sky.com/3dpubs, to find a venue near you.
Well, we knew that it was going to be tough for Plymouth Argyle tonight. The worst home record in the Championship, staring relegation in the face, and up against the Newcastle side, who are rampant, looking to make it 7 wins out of 7. Haven't gone unbeaten in 8 away for 40 years, but they are halfway to doing just that with 2 very well-executed goals here. Plymouth need 3 goals for a win, 2 goals for the point they need to keep their hopes of staying in this division alive. And Peter, you've had a few minutes to reflect. What case can you make for them?
Well, I just think that the only real trump card they've got now is Rory Fallon, and because the other guys they've got on the bench are creative midfielders, but they need to go more direct now and get more bodies forward. Did well that first half, but didn't register a goal, David.
So you expect Newcastle to be relentless?
Absolutely. I fully expect them to go and get more goals as well. You look at the strength and depth on the bench, it's amazing, really. So it's all I can see is them increasing the lead, Dave.
Time to rejoin Don Goodman and Bill Leslie.
Well, the last rites for Plymouth's stay in the Coca-Cola Championship are being prepared. They need to pull something almighty special out of the bag if they are to turn this one around. More preparations from a Newcastle perspective being made for the mother of all parties that they will have this weekend on Tyneside. The trophy, should they do what they need to do in the next 45 minutes, will be presented at St James's Park. Already, of course, sold out for the visit of Roy Keane's Ipswich. That's all to come. Still some business to be taken care of here by the men in lemon yellow, protecting that 2-goal lead. To protect it, just to remind you, they have the meanest defence in this league. And to try and get through that, one of the most shot-shy sides in the Championship this season. We said that in the first half. Able to keep reproducing what they did manage to do, Plymouth. The law of averages says that eventually something would have to give. All of them gilt-edged those chances they had, but chances they were. More than many have had against Chris Hughton and his side so far this season.
There's the positive, and I think they've got to try and take heart from that. I think the one gilt-edged chance was the header from the corner, wasn't it? The big central defender Gala had. Wasn't able to convert it. And as all good sides do, they punish you when you don't take advantage of opportunities that come your way. They need a goal pretty quickly, pretty early in this second half. For me, Plymouth, if they're to absolutely any hope of getting themselves back in it.
They nearly got one in the opening seconds of the first half. Jose Enrique in possession for Newcastle early in this second. Birthday boy Danny Guthrie. Again to help it on to Smith. Simpson back at his preferred right back position, had to fill in at centre half after the injury to Fabrizio Colaccini, which is one of the grey clouds on the horizon for Newcastle at the moment. Here comes Kevin Nolan, couldn't find a way through Eckersley. Now they're appealing for a back pass there, and from where we're looking, Don, looked like a really good case as well.
Possibly. Well, getting back in there, Eckersley. It did look like he poked the ball back to his goalkeeper.
To the Sol Campbell in Porto, perhaps.
Kevin Nolan thought he was in, and then there you go. Maybe does it just ricochet off him? I don't know. Certainly Kevin Nolan is absolutely certain that that's a back pass.
Bashira feeds Mackey. And the sting taken out of his shot by the leg of Williamson. There, signed by Newcastle just after they last won promotion to the Premier League back in 93. Signed as a backup goalkeeper to Pavel Cernacek then. And backup to pretty much everyone until this season. He has been the best goalkeeper in terms of clean sheets in Newcastle's history. A new club record already set for clean sheets, which beat that last promotion season back in the early 90s.
Talk about players in this Newcastle team that have really dominated the Championship, capable of going up to the Premier League. Well, he's certainly one of them.
with promotion secured, the celebrations, of course, will ensue, but also the debates as to who can play in the Premier League. Nolan, to turn provider, where so often he has been the scorer for Newcastle this campaign.
Looks like he's hungry for goals, doesn't he, at the start of this second half, Kevin Nolan. Very, very frequently the furthest Newcastle player forward. Very, very slow in getting back as well.
Fascinating little sideshow going on, isn't there, as to who will get the Newcastle Golden Boot. You've got Peter Lovenkrantz on the bench tonight on 15. On 18 goals, now Andy Carroll, along with Kevin Nolan. So, little battle raging.
It's incredible, isn't it? I mean, they have got goals in this Newcastle team, but going to take Jamie Mackey, Plymouth top scorer, he'd be fifth on the list of Newcastle top scorers. And that's the difference.
A priceless commodity. A prolific goal scorer. And certainly, as we mentioned about the Premier League next season for Newcastle United, that's one of the areas that might need the most attention by Chris Hughton. Did sense it was slightly tongue-in-cheek when he spoke to Dave Jones before the match. Hasn't really given next season much thought yet. Here's Judge now for Argyle. One of several who had a pretty worthy effort on Steve Harper's goal. His flash shot was wide in the later stages. It's Damian Johnson. Fletcher. Now Judge. Mackey.
Keep going. Keep trying. You can see he's a goal scorer. He wants to try and get turned and get shots in, but Paul Mariner is the fantastic striker he was. Who knows, he shouldn't be, should maybe be looking to bring others into play from those kind of areas.
That's the flip side, the other side of the coin. Newcastle await the excitements of the top tier. Plymouth Argyle have to cut their cloth accordingly for next season. Several loanees in this side, several players out of contract at the club. Sands of Championship time, almost run out now for Plymouth Argyle. And a great escape towards the end of last season. Oh, Nolan!
He's clever, isn't he? Very, very clever play. He knew that he had the defender pinned. Look, just look at him pin the big centre-half. Knows that he just needs to swivel on that. Try and get the strike away. He does it ever so well. Just can't quite keep it down. It's a decent effort. I think, basically, illustrates just why he's got so many goals from those midfield areas this season.
Scored in each of the last four Newcastle United matches, single-handedly taking up the challenge against in-form Reading last time out as well, getting both the goals there. Underscorer earlier on this season against Plymouth in that league win at St James's Park. And then as well, of course, in the FA Cup. It's a long but familiar journey to home park. The other way, these two armies of supporters offside there against Bradley Wright Phillips. Most of them are on loan. More on that in a moment, but here is their most significant attacking player, Mackey. Looks to have won the corner. Goal kick given.
It was a double deflection. It's a great spot by the referee, and Jamie Mackey, a wry smile because he knows he's trying to nutmeg to Mike Williamson here, isn't he? Just tries to flick it through and it comes back off his own leg out for a goal kick. It's a good spot by the referee.
Some you win, some you lose. Forward. Twisting and turning. Tying Bonzangala in knots. Finding Guthrie. Smith. And his persistence winning the corner.
Keep an eye on Bashir. I bet he doesn't go far off that pose this time.
He's touch tight to it, isn't it?
Yep.
An arm on it to make sure that daydreaming doesn't occur.
Steep learning curve, isn't it? They play against the top teams.
Here comes the corner. Bradley Wright Phillips playing the last line of defence. Important touch by Eckersley. Now Mackey. He's got two to take on. He'll need support. May just get it out wide to the right. Did he hold on to it too long? Even so, the ball he played didn't seem to take a bobble.
Oh, Carl Duguid really burst his neck, didn't he? Sprinted 40, 50, 60 yards to get up. And the final ball, just lacking accuracy, wasn't it? Desire, though, isn't it? Just illustrates. I won't give up, Plymouth Argyle.
Dust settles on that. It is almost certainly going to end tonight as a season of pain in terms of their survival with Plymouth Argyle. It's not about the performance they put in here, which hasn't been bad, even though they're two goals down. Newcastle have been ruthless. It's like last time out against Watford. Yeah. It's all those games that got away at the start of the season.
Yeah, it's not getting beaten against teams like Newcastle that relegate you from this division. The fact of the matter is, the teams directly above them, they've taken 5 points out of a possible 30, and that's what they're going to end up looking back on and ruin at the end of what's been a very difficult season.
Historically, when they rose up through the leagues and under Paul Sturrock and then Bobby Williamson consolidated their position here, even flirted with the playoffs under Ian Holloway. It's home form that it was built on. Here's Judge! Oh, crossbar! Super effort from Alan Judge.
Well, when you're out on your luck, you're out on your luck, because you just don't strike a football as well as this. This is an absolutely brilliant strike. Steve Harper is beaten. He's absolutely beaten. And when you're at the bottom of the league, that's invariably what happens. It hits the woodwork and bounces out, but take nothing away from that. It's a wonderful effort from Alan Judge.
If only he could have hit the target. And really needed something to happen. Judge. Duguid. Judge. It's a ball to pick out Duguid. He'll have a job on to get past one of the Championship's outstanding players. I know you're a big fan of Jose Enrique.
For me, I don't think there's been a finer player in the entire division over the course of the entire season. It really pains me, because he's not a striker. I never thought I'd be picking a left-back as my player of the Championship season, but I am.
That's one position, assuming they're able to keep hold of Jose Enrique. So he's under the spotlights of many at the World Cup. And that's one position you wouldn't think will cause Chris Eakin too much concern come next year when he comes to trying to select a Premier League side and assemble one. They're an altogether different sort of a challenge.
There's a bit of an off-the-ball incident there, spotted by Greg Pawson. Marking one or two of the players' cards.
Guthrie. Carroll did supremely well to get his head to it, but Bonsangala, in a hefty contact as he did, to watch.
It's an innocent collision, but nine times out of ten, I think Carroll would have got a free kick for that.
Bashira. Back darting into the Newcastle penalty area, but 2-0 up, closing in on the title. There's still a sea of yellow bodies back there, illustrating exactly why they are the most miserly in that department in this league. Reader Johnson, now Carroll, he's got four to take on, clipped over the top by Joey Barton, who provided that wonderful ball for Newcastle's second goal.
There was a little push in the back, wasn't there, by Andy Carroll, maybe a little bit frustrated he didn't get the previous free kick, but he's got away with it, and Newcastle have their throw.
Of blood, sweat and tears. Cheers as well, more often than not, for Newcastle United. And a half an hour away from mission accomplished, being crowned the top dogs in this league. We saw it a couple of seasons ago, didn't we, at the Britannia Stadium, the contrasts of emotions on one single day when Stoke did what they needed to do to go up, just as Leicester failed to do what they needed to do to stay up. Have the similar sort of polar extremes on show here in around half an hour's time. Because as it stands, Newcastle will be champions and Plymouth Argyle will be relegated.
I seem to remember that particular season as well. Leicester were another team that really struggled to score goals. They actually had one of the best defensive records in the league, but didn't score enough goals, and that is exactly a similar thing. What's happened to Plymouth Argyle here in terms of scoring enough goals?
When you look at Plymouth's record under Paul Mariner since about the time he took over, lost his first couple of games, but then there was a revival, and they always say you average just over a point a game, that's usually enough to stay in the league. Well, they've done that and a little bit more. 26 points from the last 22. If they'd done that over the first half of the season, then maybe they'd be all right. There are many ifs and buts that are all worthless come the final reckoning.
It's a tough job that he took on, wasn't it, in the first place, and he knew that. He truly believed that he had enough Plymouth.
Hardly right, Phillips. It's actually going to be pretty special to beat Steve Harper from there.
He struck that one in the first half, didn't he, that was difficult on the half volley. Probably gave him the confidence to take that one on. Not quite the same quality.
Confidence about to be repaid as well. Sell a few of those outside if they've got any spare. Look at the Newcastle substitutes warming up as well. Peter Lovenkrantz, who's in the race to be the top scorer. Leon Best, £2 million January signing, who hasn't really been required too much, such as the form of the others in the striking department. Shola Amiobi too. Harris would have riches compared to Plymouth. There's that battle starting to hot up between the striker and central defender. Two young men, Bonds and Gala, on loan from West Ham, and Newcastle United's Andy Carroll.
It's been a great battle, hasn't it?
And I think Andy Carroll was kept fairly quiet until he scored his goal, and then, since then, he's burst to life.
Reader Johnson got his head to that one. Andy Carroll doing his best to do so second time round, and just bulldozing his way through the crowd of players. A bit of a note given to Alan Judge from the Plymouth bench. Geordie on there as well. John Carver, famously for so long assistant to Sir Bobby Robson, St James's Park. Split emotions for him tonight. His beloved Newcastle about to be crowned champions, but his current employers about to go the other way.
Some good times, didn't he? In the northeast, John Carver. Spot on though, aren't you? Mixed emotions. Looks like they're going to change the shape of the team here. Probably going to ask Alan Judge to maybe play a little bit further forward.
Ricochet, some speed into Nolan. The head of Bonds and Gala. Well, in the sense that everything is almost lost, Plymouth have nothing to lose, if you like. Why not go for it? They need a goal, they need it from somewhere. Newcastle, by the look of things, will respond with a change of their own. Substitute slips have been given to Steve Tanner, the fourth official. Looks like Leon Best. One of the January acquisitions will be that. And by Hall. Kevin Nolan, who was taken ill, shall we say, midway through the first half. Might not be a surprise to see him replaced and Leon Best coming on. Simpson. Reader Johnson only finding a Newcastle United player. An important bit of interception that was by Damian Johnson. Guthrie. Oh, he's picked an excellent pass to Andy Carroll. Breaking into the box as well, Danny Guthrie. Carroll will enlist the help of Smith. Now Barton. And away by Damian Johnson. Mackey. He's got caught up under his feet. And the challenge is flying in, wiring in. Simpson with the one that finally saw the patience of the referee wear out.
Just shows you the hunger of Newcastle, doesn't it? The defenders try and keep this clean sheet. Very, very professional tonight.
boys from the back set up, Bonds and Gala, Rita Johnson. Judge who's done plenty good tonight, not getting that one quite right.
Disappointing, he holds his hand up because he knows he needs to be better than that, and you're right. Particularly in the second half, several bright moments, Alan Judge.
The realisation dawns on most of home park. The fate is about to be. It's a quarter of a match, just under, in fact, before it's rubber stamped by the mathematics and Plymouth are relegated. Toon Army in one corner of the stadium, ramping up their celebrations. The goal will help. Served that purpose very nicely. Here's Wayne Ratledge, just too close to David Stockdale.
He only had Andy Carroll to aim for, didn't he? He was at full pelt, Wayne Ratledge.
The Shearer, cut out by Williamson. Offside flag was up anyway. Newcastle will make the first of a double substitution. Second will follow on in double quick time as well. It's a new strike force.
Substitution coming off, number four, Kevin Nolan.
Kevin Nolan.
Going on, Leon Best.
A well-deserved rest. He is not looking the best. He's certainly not feeling the best.
Andrew Carroll.
On comes Leon Best. Shona Amiobi as well to replace Andy Carroll. He's completed his personal double in the league against Plymouth, scored at St James's. Now he's scored down in the southwestern outpost of the Football League. Just what you don't want if you're a Plymouth Argyle defender.
Just highlights the strength and depth that they have, doesn't it, Newcastle United? Of all the goal scorers we've mentioned, actually Shola Amiobi. Best goals to game ratio, 9 league goals and 15 starts.
Almost caught in a Newcastle sandwich there, Judge, who was stricken. It's a high boot from Best. Signals everyone to get up. A few just lurking on the halfway line, not anymore. Stockdale launches it forward. Jose Enrique brings it out. Could be caught out here because, as we just said, many resources committed to attack. Leon Best trying to make up the ground.
That's a free kick, the skipper, doesn't he? But not sure it wasn't exhaustion. Let's not forget, he's missed a few weeks. It was under pressure, wasn't it, from Leon Best?
The new boys in the Newcastle attack bring new threats. Leon Best was closest to it. Enrique, Wayne Ratledge. And it's Ratledge who's been penalised. Judge. Ratledge will certainly be penalised this time.
I think he's had a good game, you know. Very important. About spot on with everything he's done.
The young referee hasn't refereed a lot at this level. It's only his sixth ever championship match. side of Barton's head. Well inside the last 20 minutes now, Don, and Paul Mariner, as yet, keeping the same side he started with. Amiobi nearly in here. Stockdale, and judged to have been fouled by Shola Amiobi.
Right smile. Often, in my opinion, goalkeeper's overprotected. Jumps into him. I think, again, the referee's got that right. Shola Amiobi has a little look at the goalkeeper, doesn't he, as he's coming. That's a free kick.
Substitution coming off next
in. Here comes the first change for Argyle. They're sending a boy on to do a man's job, if you like. 18-year-old Republic of Ireland under-19 international Joe Mason, local lad through the academy. What can he do to halt the slide? Judge, just an increasing element of desperation about what Plymouth are trying, understandably so. They really need three goals here to avoid what is looking increasingly inevitable. More action for you for the Championship as the season comes to a climax. West Bromwich Albion, well, business taken care of for them, but not so Crystal Palace. We have it live for you next Monday night, 7:30, Sky Sports HD 1&1. Eckersley, Judge, Jose Enrique,
almost in cruise control, aren't they, really, Newcastle, and probably have been since they took the lead in this game. Must have known with Argyle, not the most prolific team, so they're back themselves defensively to withstand most everything. It's proved to be the case so far.
Funny enough, given the fact that they're so strong at the back, they actually come into this match on the back of one of their worst defensive spells of the season, though clean sheet in their last four since that pivotal win at home against Nottingham Forest.
It is one of their worst defensive spells, isn't it? They've conceded 13 goals in 14 games. Most of the Championship would die for statistics like that.
When you set the bar high, I suppose you fall below that high standards. And, it does appear poor, but you say, Don, they have been the bar setters for this league this season. Offside flag. Trying to deny the local boy.
Pretty close from up here. Does he just set off a smidgen too soon? Look at that line that Newcastle have got there. It's a perfect defensive line, and the young man just sets off a fraction too early.
I suppose in one sense, it's not going to come as a shock to the supporters of Plymouth, the fact that this is the fate for them at the end of the season. It stings when it's actually confirmed, black and white. Away by Bonds and Gala. I think you almost said it at the time, Don, when those three early chances went to begging. Mackie in particular, that header from Bonds and Gala from point-blank range, and then Mackie had another shot shortly afterwards, didn't he? When those all went to begging, you thought they needed those, they really needed those if something was going to happen tonight.
The big thing for Plymouth Argyle tonight was getting the first goal, I always felt. It just didn't happen for them.
Gala.
Hey.
Amiobi. It's nearly worked to Judge. He's away, advantage play. Has failed to pick out Mackey. Bodies on the line for Newcastle there, Williamson and Simpson. Slip from Best. Fletcher, the Argyle captain, finding the youngster Mason. Guthrie. Simpson still feeling the back of his head after that piece of defensive bravery, if you like. Johnson, Bashira, and there now, aren't they? They're as good as there now. Free kick. Seems to come off the hand of Routledge. Up goes the assistance flag on this near side. Starter recently for Argyle, attacking midfield player, missed out in the 11 tonight, but he comes on for the last 10 minutes.
Season to such a disappointment last season. The players have done their bit. Doing something that's not easy, is it? And straight back after being relegated from the Premier League. It's proven to be a difficult task, but 15 out of 52, I think, have done it. Newcastle have done it at a canter, haven't they?
With the backdrop of uncertainty, and without wanting to overstress it. The state that the club was seemingly in pre-season with players leaving almost seemed like a little bit of a fire sale, the owner desperate to get rid of all the uncertainty that that brought. To then put in a season like this, of course they didn't even have a permanent manager then. One thought that Alan Shearer might be back. Chris Hughton seemed to just be holding the fort. And he's made that job his own, he's made the side his own. In that image, he has created the best side in this league, the champions.
It's testimony to the job that Shuten and the players and coaching staff have done, that most of those off-field dramas have been forgotten by most people.
And we'll be talking about what they're doing on the field tonight, that's for sure. Offside flag. Substitute Balassi lost his feet. The Green Army responding to their Toon counterparts.
Most hope. Can get off to a good start next season in League One. And see their club back up to the Championship.
This looks like an enforced substitution. Mitchell has only just come back from the long spell on the sidelines. Is he going to be able to see it through? Tamás Kadar is going to come on. He's been a bit of a peripheral figure this season, the young Hungarian. But, when the numbers are down and players are missing at the heart of defence, he's called up. And this is one of those occasions. Players who's hardly featured for the Magpies this season is going to be on the field when they are crowned champions. in 6.5 minutes time or so. Leon Best, oh, clever feint from Best, oh, crossbar denies him. That would have been a fine way to crown it, wouldn't it? Now Guthrie. Routledge. Seems to be a push from Best, and it's been given.
Oh, he was in the thick of the action there, wasn't he? 30 seconds. What a strike this is. We've seen a few good strikes tonight, but this is up there with the best of them. Absolutely. The pace beats Stockdale. The direction is brilliant. Again, just crashes against the crossbar. Super effort.
Pretty big price tag, and as yet has been unable to get his first goal for Newcastle. That would have been timing. Trip of over 800 miles, seemed like it's worth every yard, every second, every minute spent in the car. This is probably one of those days, certainly for those in black and white. Routledge. Williamson's header.
They're enjoying themselves out there, you know, these Newcastle players. Putting on a bit of an exhibition for the supporters now.
Jose Enrique Barton! Fine save, Stockdale. Can't have seen too much of that.
It's just instinctive, isn't it? Stuck out a leg.
The keeper on loan from a Premier League club, pulling out a top draw save.
Jerry Barton must have thought net was going to bulge here. Enrique does well, squares it, and well, it's just instinctive, isn't it, from Stockdale. Good save.
Best, Amiobi. Routledge is striding forward in space as well. Guthrie. Still Danny Guthrie. No appeal for handball, it's not going to come. Best, he's put it over.
Exhibition stuff, just one touch football, nice and neat. Great skill by Danny Guthrie, pulls off a couple of challenges. Lets that goal, does that strike Eckersley on the arm, maybe been a bit harsh, struck with venom underside of the elbow, so no penalty for me. But then Leon Best again, still waiting, just can't keep that down.
Yeah, Guthrie, as he made his way forward there, and it just seemed like it might open up. Thought that he'd crown his 23rd birthday with a goal. All a happy irrelevance for all those gathered behind the Plymouth goal in the second half, and for all of you watching on Tyneside. Alassi trying to make an impact, here's Mason!
It's a shame, it may only have been a consolation, but young local boy, would have been a sweet moment. Lassie does well, doesn't he? Great skill there. I'm not sure that little prod there is for Mason, but the defender misses the tackle. Just opens up for the young man. He can't hit the target. Story of the season, Plymouth Argyle.
Just a few celebrations starting to break out on the bench. Chris Hughton has done a pretty good poker face this season, hasn't he? But he's very nearly not exceeded expectations, but certainly satisfied demand. And goodness me, is there demand on Tyneside. Jose Enrique. Guthrie. Going to try and dance his way through again. Leon Best. Enrique, they're really seeking a third here. Cut out by young Bonsangala. Routledge. Balassi away. Fletcher. Eckersley. As going down with a bang and going down with a whimper, they haven't been able to beat Steve Harper yet, but they've had a pretty good go here tonight, Plymouth Argyle. And as we said earlier on, Don, the damage has been done in the early months of the season, not really what they're doing now in the last embers of it.
Given a go, haven't they? They've given it a go here tonight. I don't think anybody can doubt the desire and effort and commitment that they've shown. Sadly, distinct class in difference in class, isn't there? And it's been there for all to see tonight.
Nine months of long work, and it has come down to seconds now for Chris Hughton and for Newcastle. Shoulder on the OB.
He wanted a goal, didn't he? Big fella.
That seemed to come off Williamson hand. The referee hasn't given it 3 minutes. That's how long the wait will go on. On the positive side for Newcastle and on the most painful side for Plymouth Argyle. Let's not forget there were two sides to this championship coin here this evening. Pleasure and pain, success and failure, victory and defeat. Both about to be demonstrated in sharp contrast.
Start this evening's game, wasn't it, anyway, facing the champions elect and then away to Nottingham Forest, who's home for beaten for 18 games or something like that. Always going to be difficult for Plymouth Argyle.
And it's all there for them, isn't it? The championship, that record points total on target for 100 against Ipswich. Party at the weekend when they will receive the trophy. They can go through a whole league season unbeaten. These happy records all stack up when you get the sort of success week in, week out that Newcastle have been able to achieve this season. Williamson at full stretch. There's Guthrie. Kadar. Enrique bobbles through to Barton. The last minute of the signal three now. And Newcastle get goal number three. Will there be any change in the level of noise coming from the Newcastle fans? Have they scored or not? May well be Plymouth on the night. Steve Harper will want to be clean to preserve the clean sheet. And he has his Spanish fullback to thank for doing just that.
Wouldn't you just know it? Man on the line for Newcastle. Clears it off the line.
There's the power of Shonarami Obi. Breezes beyond Damian Johnson. Puts it into an area where Duguid is patrolling. Newcastle United, they are the champions of the championship. On the longest journey that they have to make in any season, they have made the most significant step. They knew they were promoted, now they are the best. Their goals on the night came in the first half Andy Carroll with the first and Wayne Rutledge with the second. Just another win, just another piece of business taken care of en route to crowning themselves as the number one side in this league. And over the whole 9 months of the season, Don, no one, but no one will argue that they have been the best.
Yeah, they have been the best in every way, shape and form. They've withstood the challenge of a very strong West Bromwich Albion team. They've withstood the challenge of every single game, the opposition going into the game, wanting to take their scalp. And congratulations to Newcastle United. And commiserations to Plymouth, of course.
There is the flip side. Visitors' ecstasy, home side's agony. A six-year stay at this level has come to an end for Plymouth Argyle. And while they come to terms with that, they have to watch the celebrations from Newcastle United. They will go on all the way up the M5, the nation's motorways, back to Tyneside. And the parties will have burst out already, I'm sure. Freddie Mercury doing his bit. Newcastle have done their bit. And what a contrast to the pain, to the desperation, the desolation of 12 months ago. That insipid performance at Villa Park when they went out of the Premier League with a whimper. Now they are back with a bang. Coming to terms with the fact that they will be competing in League One next season. As we said earlier on, Don, they've been known it's coming for a while, but the reality of it make it any easier now that this defeat has confirmed what they probably already knew.
It's still painful, isn't it? And of course, they're watching on, black and white celebrations. I think the thing for Plymouth is they're used to seeing their team be very, very difficult to beat here at Home Park, but that just hasn't materialised this season. Just 5 home wins. Who would have thought that?
Well, these are happy scenes, really happy scenes. Players and supporters as one out there. Andy Carroll, who got the first. And this party will continue on the Saturday at St James's when they get the trophy, but tonight they've won it and they've done enough again. Final score on the night, Plymouth 0, Newcastle 2. Newcastle United, champions of the Championship.
Peter Beagrie is watching on with us. Even those Newcastle players who haven't been involved tonight have managed to get themselves on the pitch. Do players enjoy this, celebrating with the fans, Peter?
Yeah, to a degree. It gets a bit scary when you look at the volumes of people there, really, but I'm surprised some of them are still fully clothed, really. Been involved in scenes like this before on a smaller scale, I must admit. But justifiably, the fans celebrate. And it's been a monumental achievement by Newcastle this year.
You have to say as well, well done to the Plymouth fans for showing a great deal of restraint amid a lot of provocation. Remember, it's been a very emotional night for them as well here. Here's confirmation that Newcastle are the champions. West Brom cannot catch them, but they are heading back to the Premier League as well. Forest and Cardiff, as we said at the top, guaranteed their place in the playoffs. Leicester, Swansea and Blackpool will battle it out for those 2 remaining playoff places. Peterborough down, and so too now Plymouth down as well. One off, Sheffield Wednesday, Crystal Palace, Watford and Scunthorpe will join them. Sheffield Wednesday and Palace, remember, will meet on the final day of the season, which is why Plymouth are down tonight. Newcastle needed a point to be confirmed champions. They managed 3 with 2 first-half goals and sent Plymouth down in the process. They managed to rescue a couple of their heroes from the pitch. Wayne Routledge off to meet Greg Whelan, and so too Kevin Nolan.
Kevin, congratulations. You're going up as champions. Would you have settled for anything less?
No. No, no, no. That's what we wanted. As soon as we got the promotion. As soon as we got the promotion, you know, that's exactly what we wanted. And you know, we haven't laid up. We wanted it, and we've got it. And it's going to all, hopefully, you know, it's going to sink in probably this week. But Massive credit must go to all the staff and the lads for the effort they've put in. And, you know, we've got a massive season in the Premier League to look forward to now.
Kevin, a point would have been enough here tonight. How important was it to you as players to go up in style?
Yeah, I mean, we wanted to win the game, you know. We've won our, I think it was last eight. I think that makes it 9 wins on the spin now. So, I mean, we said that we didn't want to, you know, hold up. But after the Forest game, we wanted to go on now and keep winning games. And we've got a few little records to break still. So now we're looking at records and we've gone up as champions. It's fantastic and, you know, absolutely delighted and, you know, long making. You know,
I can see it in your face. Let's grab a word with the scorer of the second goal. Wayne, terrific goal. How important was it to get it when you did? Because Plymouth had started well.
Yeah, they started well. They're fighting for their lives and they started well. But obviously it's important to get goals at the right times and I feel we did that today.
You joined this football club for Premier League football. How much are you looking forward to going into the Premier League with Newcastle?
Yeah, I mean, I really can't explain it in words. Obviously, everyone wants to play Premier League football and I'm no different. And obviously, to come here in January and obviously getting a team that's performing as well as it is, it's a great achievement and we're just all happy to be where we are right now.
Last one to you, Kevin. There'll be plenty of celebrations after this, I'm sure. But will you be well enough to partake?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, I'm going to be well enough for that. And we are going to party. We're going to enjoy this. We're definitely going to enjoy this. But we're not going to take Saturday lightly. You know, we've got a fantastic home record, and we're going to make sure that we keep that intact. So, obviously, no letting up. And you know what Chris is like. he'll make sure he's on top of us after a couple of days of enjoying this.
Well, congratulations on your success, Wayne. You're the parade man of the match tonight. Kevin, if you do the honours for us, please.
Well done, sir.
Congratulations.